Typically, Mr. Thomas splits your section in halves, keeping one group in the main room and one in a breakout room. When you're in the main room, you almost always will be working on the newest assignment that appears in the Math Proficiency Development Classwork tab in Google Classroom. Mr. Thomas might play a video or do some demonstrating in the beginning of class, but usually he gives most of the class period for you to be working and asking questions if you need to. Be aware you get two grades for these assignments. One grade happens during class. If you are working, Mr. Thomas will have your documents open and be overseeing your progress. He might ask you some questions or make some suggestions while you are working. You are also welcome to ask questions of your own when you get stuck, confused, or need help. If you're not working, or if you're working inconsistently, Mr. Thomas will reduce your effort points that day. There are five levels of effort and engagement that we recognize. Solid, on and off, minimal effort will get you a passing score for the day. Icon drop and absent are considered failing grades in the classwork category. It's important that if you are working and you do not see Mr. Thomas's icon inside of the document where you are working, you let him know, "Mister, this is where you need to look for my work today." If you want to appeal a low effort grade and give me information about what was preventing you from working on a specific day, you can click on a Google Form link inside of Infinite Campus at the place where the assignment was graded to explain your situation. That form looks like this. It's very simple. Your name, first and last, what's the name of the assignment that you were supposed to be working on that day, and the reason or explanation for your absence or inactivity. I said that you get two grades for your tasks in the main room. The second grade will be a 30% grade in the performance-based learning category, and that will be based on how well you did on the assignment. That grade will be given over the weekend after the assignment is due. Together, 20% for effort during class plus 30% for correctness and completeness by the end of the week is half of your overall grade in math proficiency development. When you're in a breakout room, unless told to do otherwise, you will want to be completing one Imagine Math lesson. Completing a lesson means either that you pass the pre-quiz or that you do all five parts of the lesson, including finishing a post-quiz. When you go into Imagine Math, there's an option to choose different pathways. Some of you already have more than one pathway assigned to your account before coming into third report period. All of you have a pathway now that is called Thomas Alternative Pathway, which is optional but strongly suggested. If you choose to follow the Thomas Alternative Pathway, I've got a couple extra things in place for you. One of them is me going through the pathway before you get to it and linking either to a video I've already done, or I'll create a new video if I don't have one for that topic yet. So inside of this document, which will be inside of the Imagine Math assignment in Google Classroom, this week, starting off very simple, just so that you can see how this works, the first lesson in the Thomas Alternative Pathway is solving two-step equations. Most of you probably can pass the pre-quiz and be done. But if this has been something you've been struggling with, I have a YouTube link to me explaining, so before you even go and look at the pre-quiz, or after you finish the pre-quiz, if you haven't passed it and whatever Imagine Math is doing isn't making a lot of sense to you, you can check my own explanation for how to solve one and two-step equations. Also, let's say you get all the way through the lesson, clicked all the way through it, took the post-quiz, still failed the post-quiz. I'm giving you an option to take a quiz from me. That's what this is right here. It's called an after quiz. It's two questions long, and it'll let you get almost a perfect score, even if you fail the Imagine Math lesson, as long as you get it done on time, meaning by Friday. Okay? These charts right here, green, if you're completing your lesson on time, these are the point values that you can get based on different scenarios. Yellow, if you decide to do it late. Significant reduction in points. So let's get them done on time, and of course, if you don't do the lesson, that's a failing grade, right?